Hello, dear children. Let us learn standard 8th and 9th chemistry ICSE syllabus atomic structure. In this video, our objective is to learn the following topics: atom, discovery of electron, properties of cathode rays, discovery of protons, properties of anode rays, and plum pudding model. Children, what is an atom? Generally, we define atom as an atom is the smallest particle of an element that exhibit all the properties of that element. And we know very well that atoms are the fundamental building blocks of all types of matter. The physical and chemical properties of matter are determined by atoms. It is the atom of an element that takes part in chemical reaction. But what is an atom made up of, and what about its structure? Let us learn. So let us start today's session with the topic discovery of electron. Okay, children, who discovered electron? William Crook. Okay, William Crook was the scientist, British scientist, who discovered electron. He performed an experiment. So what was the experiment? He took one discharge tube. So what do you mean by discharge tube? This is the discharge tube. Okay, what do you mean by discharge tube? A discharge tube is a hard glass tube. It is a hard glass tube fitted with two metal plates. These are the two metal plates. Okay, and they are called as electrodes. One is we are having two electrodes here. One is your cathode, another one is your anode. Cathode is connected to the negative terminal, and anode, it is connected to the positive terminal. Okay, and here we are also having one vacuum pump. Now, what is the use of this vacuum pump? With the help of this vacuum pump, the gases can be pumped out. Okay, the gases can be pumped out. Now, he performed the experiment like this. First of all, he filled this glass tube with gases at very low pressure. What was the pressure, children? It was 0.01 mm of Hg. 0.01 mm of Hg. And inside this discharge tube, the voltage was very high, that is 10,000 volt. Okay, so he started the experiment by filling the tube with gases, and the voltage of this the voltage inside the discharge tube was 10,000 volt, and pressure was very low, that is 0.01 mmHg. He observed that when the experiment was started, he observed that the gases which were inside this discharge tube, they started to flow from cathode to anode. Okay, they started to flow from cathode to anode in the form of rays, that is blue rays. Okay, since these rays were moving from cathode to anode, so they were called as cathode rays. Okay, they were called as cathode rays. Later on, the properties of the cathode rays were discovered by the scientist J.J. Thomson. Okay, he studied the characteristics and the constituents of cathode rays, or we can say that the properties of cathode rays. Now, what he observed during his experiment, he observed that cathode rays are always moving in a straight line. Okay, cathode rays are always moving in a straight line. That is, from cathode to anode, it's moving, and it's moving in a straight line. Now, second thing that he observed was, when he took negatively charged plate and positively charged plate, and when he kept those two plates in the path of the cathode rays, he observed that since cathode rays are negatively charged particles, so they were moving towards the positively charged, or we can say that they are inflected towards the positive field and deflected from the negative field. Okay, he also found that when an object is placed in the path of the cathode rays, a shadow was cast behind it, behind the object. Okay, shadow was cast behind the object. He also studied that when a paddle wheel was placed in the path of the cathode rays, the paddle wheel started rotating. Okay, the paddle wheel started rotating. Okay, so he also found that this cathode rays are possessing kinetic energy. okay, these cathode rays are possessing kinetic energy by this experiment, okay, because these cathode rays were able to move or rotate the paddle wheel. Okay, so let us summarize some properties of cathode rays. So, properties of cathode rays are, they travel from the cathode to anode in a straight line. Okay, they are deflected by magnetic and electric field. That means cathode rays are negatively charged particle, so they are attracted towards the positive terminal. Okay, they have kinetic energy, that is, they raise the temperature of a metallic object on which they fall. When an object was placed in front of cathode rays, a shadow of the object was cast behind it. Okay, when a small paddle wheel was placed in front of cathode rays, it was observed to rotate. That means cathode rays were almost of particle nature, imparting momentum. Now, what do you mean by momentum? Momentum is nothing but mass into velocity. That means these all properties were saying about the particle nature of cathode rays, and they consist of particle and they have mass and velocity. Now, what do you mean? What is the mass of an electron? Mass of an electron is 9.107 into 10 to the power minus 28 gram. And what is the charge of an electron? It is minus 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. Let us learn the next topic, discovery of proton. Children, atoms are found to be electrically neutral. Yes, atoms are electrically neutral. That means if they are having a negatively charged particle, then they must contain a positively charged particle also, and the negatively charged particle should be, the number of negatively charged particles should be equal to the total number of positively charged particles. Yes or no? So this realization led to the discovery of proton, that is, the other name of proton is Cannell rays. So who discovered proton, children? Goldstein. Okay, Goldstein discovered proton. Now he performed an experiment. So what was the experiment? He did the same arrangement, that is, a discharge tube, a vacuum pump, okay, and electrode, that is cathode and anode. The anode was connected to the positive terminal, cathode was connected to the negative terminal. So now what he did is, instead of cathode, he took perforated cathode. Perforated cathode is like this. Okay, what do you mean by perforated cathode? Perforated cathode is nothing but your cathode, but consisting of holes in it. Okay, so now what he did, he took perforated cathode in place of cathode. Now when the experiment was performed in the presence of high voltage and low pressure, he observed that two set of rays were moving. In the experiment, he found two set of rays. One set of rays were traveling towards anode. Okay, since they were the emitted from the cathode, that means they were the negatively charged particles and they were moving towards anode. Now, the second set of rays were traveling in a direction opposite to that of the cathode rays. Means this is the another set of rays and they were traveling in the direction opposite to that of the cathode rays. The direction of the second set of rays were such that they were moving from anode to cathode. That's why the name was given as anode rays. Okay, the name was given as anode rays, and they were positive rays. The other name of these rays was Cannell rays. Why they were called as Cannell rays, children? Because these rays were able to pass through holes or canals in the perforated cathode. That's why the name was given as Cannell rays. Okay, so now let us summarize the properties of Cannell rays, that is, the anode or positive rays.
So now, after getting the idea about anode rays, let us summarize the properties of anode rays. They are, anode rays travel in a straight line. They are made up of positively charged particles. They are also deflected by electric and magnetic field, but in the direction opposite to cathode rays. What is the mass of proton? It is 1.670 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. And what is the charge of proton? It is nothing but equal to plus 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Children, cathode rays are negatively charged particle. So, charge of electron is given as minus 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. But anode rays are positively charged particles. So, here charge is given as plus 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs.
Now let us learn the next topic, that is plum pudding model. After the discovery of electrons and protons, J.J. Thomson proposed plum pudding model. So this plum pudding model was proposed by J.J. Thomson. According to this plum pudding model, an atom is considered to be a sphere of unit positive charge and electrons were embedded on it. Electrons were embedded on it like your plum in your pudding. Okay, and the total number of positive charge is equal to total number of negative charge present in an atom, so that an atom as a whole is electrically neutral. Okay, and also the mass of an atom is considered to be uniformly distributed. The mass of an atom, that means the distribution of electrons and protons were uniform. Okay, now let us discuss the ratio of the charge to mass of the particle, that is E by M of cathode rays and anode rays. Okay, in case of cathode rays, the ratio of the charge to mass of the particle, that is the E by M value, is given as 1.76 into 10 to the power 11 coulomb per kg. Okay, coulomb per kg. That means here, it does not, the value does not depends upon the nature of the gas taken, okay, and the metal performing the cathode. But in case of anode rays, the E by M or the charge to mass ratio differs from gas to gas, okay, differs from gas to gas, and its value is much less than that of an electron. Okay, this is all about your plum pudding model.